The island of Cyprus is famous for its crystal clear waters, scenic landscapes, and sunny climates. Legend holds that Cyprus is the birthplace of Aphrodite, goddess of love and beauty, and it is affectionately known as the island of Amore. Boasting some of the most amazing sunsets in the world, it's no wonder that so many couples are choosing Cyprus as their dream wedding destination. Cyprus has long been known as a sun, sea and sand destination. With an idyllic Mediterranean setting and all kinds of hidden treasures, Cyprus is fast developing a reputation as the perfect place to tie the knot.
Well, when you come to Cyprus, obviously you have the weather for a start, the people are so friendly, and obviously you here, you have your wedding and your honeymoon in one go.
Because of the sunshine, it does give you a feel-good factor, so you're quite happy most days of the year as well. I think in England, a lot of people have the mentality of, well, I finish at 5, and you've asked me that question at 5 to 5, so I really can't be bothered. Here in Cyprus, our mentality is, if it's achievable, then we will do it. We will go the extra mile to give them what they want, because that's what we're here for. And I just think people are generally more friendly, very laid back, and probably how England was 20 years ago.
Situated in the Mediterranean between Europe, Africa and the Middle East, Cyprus offers the best of all worlds for those looking for a romantic wedding abroad. As one of the earliest cultures to embrace Christianity, the island is scattered with cute little chapels, which could have come straight from the set of Mamma Mia. But whether it's a chapel of love you're looking for, a love boat, or a civil ceremony, there are a wealth of wedding venues to choose from.
We are Mr. and Mrs. Horrocks, and we've been married about 30 seconds. Yeah. We've been together, 7 years now?
8 years in November. Yeah. So, yeah.
Yeah. We've been here before a couple of times on holiday. Yeah. Really love the place. Yeah, just really like the idea of getting married in the sun and abroad. Definitely. We didn't really know what to expect.
We've been in a different country.
Yeah, it's worked out really well.
Yeah, it's worked out fine, hasn't it?
To get married in Cyprus can be 3 times cheaper than it is in UK, and can be organised in a lot shorter time.
It is a lot cheaper still, despite the various economic situation around the world. It is much, much cheaper to get married abroad. I mean, if you think, we only charge £200 for an administration fee, and that's for me on one side amending the menus, and your wedding coordinator, as you arrive here, who actually looks after you right up to the day of the wedding once you've said, I do, which is the only thing we don't do for you.
I got my dress and everything in an hour. Somebody was looking after my little girl, and I literally got the wedding dress, the veil, my tiara, all in an hour, my shoes, the full works. Mm. So, no, once you've got that, you're all right.
We can organise all different types of weddings. There are civil weddings, church weddings, which are Anglican or Catholics, and we can also do renewals of the vows.
So a bride and groom would come on to us either direct or via travel agent, and basically we help them with everything. So from the booking of the date and time of the wedding, which is something we do unlike other people, we actually reserve everything for them, the hotel or the registry office.
We as a company can arrange anything and everything for the clients, whatever their demands are, starting from flowers, cakes, music, Cyprus dancers, different venues. Basically, we can arrange anything they require.
We do a very tailor-made wedding. So basically, I normally say to the bride, whatever you want, we do.
We met everybody first. We've met the driver, we've met the registrar before today. Mm. So it's nice because you've got familiar faces before you actually meet. You know, so you kind of recognise everybody, and everybody's been great. Mm. Like you say, you kind of know them, it's like friends then, do you know what I mean? So it's not like you've just got this person in front of you, you've got somebody that you've been talking to.
Then we have to go through all the process. Where do you want your wedding? Do you want it in the registry office? Do you want it indoors, outdoors? Do you want it in the ground of the hotel? Do you want it on the yacht? Do you want it on the beach? On the beach, I mean feet in the sand. There are just a few places in Cyprus where we can do it. So really, we give them all sorts of ideas for them to decide, because at the end of of the day, is their wedding, is their day, they choose.
It's a good feel factor as well. You're always surrounded by loads of positive energy because everybody's really, really happy. And it's just lovely to work from a blank canvas, put together their day that they want. We don't tell them what they're going to have, they tell me what they want. And it's nice to create that, and then you're just proud on the day that it's come together and that you've made them really have the wedding of their dreams, really, because that's what it's all about.
I think my sister's coming back next year for
to
her
do
wedding,
it all so again, so...
Yeah. Yep.
We're trendsetters.
The warmth and hospitality of the Cypriot people is just one of the reasons why couples are choosing Cyprus for their special day. Those who are looking for the five-star treatment will find that Cyprus has a fantastic range of luxury hotels which have embraced the wedding trend.
Hi, I'm Kerry Barker. I'm the wedding coordinator here at the Coral Beach Hotel in Coral Bay in Paphos, Cyprus. The Coral Beach Hotel is set in Coral Bay, gorgeous, quiet area of Cyprus. Two fabulous beaches close by, as well as a private beach of the hotel. Here we are in the spacious reception area of the hotel. As you can see, we've got typical Cypriot architecture here. We have 422 rooms at the hotel, five restaurants, two of which are a la carte. On site we also have a health club, spa, hairdressers, tennis courts and the Olympic-sized swimming pool. Prior to your wedding ceremony, you and your guests can meet in the Dionysus bar. Here we can serve for you soft drinks, cocktails, spirits or beers. You can choose to sit inside or outside, overlooking the gardens and the Mediterranean Sea. Here we are on the Aphrodite Terrace, again keeping in the theme of the hotel, traditional Cypriot setup. Here you can hold your pre-wedding drinks or the pre-dinner drinks. Again, this is another suitable location for large groups and another stunning location of the hotel. The first wedding location I'm going to show you, our most popular location, is the Armonia Terrace. When I get to this point here, our wedding couples usually go, wow, look at that view. And once the couples have taken in the magnificent view, I will then tell the bride, this is your grand entrance. The guests are sitting in front of you, all turning round, taking pictures as you make your way down. Wow at your dress. Bridesmaids following. You make your way down to the red carpet. And this is one of the ceremony setups here on the Armonia Terrace. As you can see, we've got the stunning view behind me. This is all undercover, so it's nice and cool for yourself and your guests. As you can see, we have the white linen chair covers, and we also have the registrar's table behind me, where the registrar will stand, along with yourself and the best man. And we can comfortably have around 50 guests in this area. This is the most popular area for a wedding ceremony and reception of the hotel because of the fact that it's shaded and the stunning views, very private. And recently, I've even had somebody from the UK cancel their wedding over there and rebook for the Armonia Terrace here. We set up for the ceremony early every morning, and then prior to the guests' arrival to the hotel, we make sure that everything is clean, tidy, pristine, and set up as they require. Here at the hotel, we have this large swimming pool, along with two children's pools, an indoor pool, and the Olympic-sized swimming pool. Fun for everybody. The cool shaded deck area is perfect for after ceremony cocktails and your wedding dinner. More suitable for a smaller party, and we can serve the mezze and the barbecue in this area. So I've shown you the Armonia Terrace, and now I'd like to show you our second option, which is the amphitheatre. First of all though, I'd like to show you the walk that you would have over to the amphitheatre. First of all, coming through the beautiful gardens here at the Coral Beach Hotel, you've got the sea directly in front of you, and the bride and her bridesmaids will walk along the seafront. And then towards the harbour before we enter the amphitheatre. And here we are in the amphitheatre, which is situated next to the lovely tranquil marina here. Once your ceremony has finished down in the amphitheatre, it's a great location for having cocktails and canapes, and if you choose, we can go straight over to the Limani Taverna for your dinner. We have a number of different areas here at the hotel for your wedding dinner, but for a smaller party, you might prefer to dine in one of our a la carte restaurants. Here we're in the Romanzino restaurant, and it's light, cool, airy, and in the evening time, fantastic. With the curtains open, you can see the flowers and the Mediterranean Sea, and there are also tables outside. And this is just one of our options and my personal favourite. For any couples that are watching and they're thinking about Cyprus as a location for their wedding, I'd say yes, definitely come over to Cyprus. It's a gorgeous island, the island of love. come to the Coral Beach Hotel. You will have an excellent day and it will be relaxed and chilled out.
But holidays in Cyprus are not all about luxury hotels and beaches. The history and culture of the island dates back thousands of years, and the influence of ancient Greek mythology is still present today.
According to the Greek mythology, the goddess of love, Aphrodite, rose from the waves in this place here. And according to the legend as well, if you were to swim naked around the rock at night in full moon, then you will find true love. If you were to translate the word Petra Duromiu, is translated into English, the rock of the Greek. And according to the mythology again, there was a frontier guard named the Genis Agridas, and he used the rocks against the advancing ships of the Arab Saracens that they were invading the island.
Coming up, we speak to more couples who have tied the knot on the Island of Love. Take a look at another of Cyprus's most luxurious hotels and pay a visit to a traditional Cypriot home. Cyprus is fast becoming one of the world's premier wedding and honeymoon destinations, and its delightful mix of sun, sea and sand attracts around 2.4 million visitors every year. Couples who enjoy discovering local history and culture will find that Cyprus has plenty to offer.
Here we have St. Paul's Pillar, where according to religious history, St. Paul was flogged by the Romans when he visited Cyprus in one of his journeys. Cyprus, and especially Paphos, was the capital at the times, and Paul came here to preach Christianity, and the Romans, obviously being pagans, they ordered him flogged in an attempt to make him leave the island. At the end, the governor of the times, the Roman governor of Cyprus, he saw the light and he converted into Christianity. The church here, Agia Kyriaki, is used by the Anglican community or the British community of Cyprus for their religious ceremonies. They hold, let's say, Sunday Mass, they will hold weddings here and christenings, and you know, this is a very, very old church.
Planning a wedding abroad can be a daunting prospect. Luckily, specialist tour operators based in Britain and Cyprus can help couples get started on the preparations before they've even left home.
Cyprus is a very beautiful island, and it's the Island of Love. To have a wedding in Cyprus is very special because you can have your wedding as well as your honeymoon at the same time.
We are based in London and we have a team of wedding coordinators both in London and in Cyprus.
Most of the aspects of the wedding are arranged back in the UK. Our job role here is to meet the couple, to recap everything what needs to be done, take them to the town hall to do the legal side of things, the paperwork, the legal paperwork, and arrange any extras they may want in the resort.
It's very important, I believe, for clients to actually go through a specialist wedding operator. Not only can we save them money on paperwork such as affidavit, instead of having to go to a solicitor in UK and paying quite a lot of money per paper, we actually do it in Cyprus just for not even 10 euros for two.
What we're doing is, before the couple actually arrive, we make all the relevant appointments at the town hall or the church meeting with the vicars, etc. Sometimes I've met them before, which is a bonus, and we've already agreed flowers, photography, transport, hair, makeup, beauty, pedicures, etc. if they want any music or entertainment. So we've already got a basis idea before they arrive of what they want for their wedding. When the couple do arrive, then there's a welcome pack waiting for them with my details in. The very next morning, I go meet them, we sit, have a coffee and orange juice, and then after that meeting, they lie on a sunbed, and basically it's down to me to do everything for their wedding day, so they don't have anything else to do after that initial morning.
It all depends on their budget, basically. They can have very small parties. We've had parties just with two, bride and groom, and whereby the wedding coordinator will then act as the witness. Or they can have a huge big group, 50, 60 people. We can arrange, as I said, a reception in hotels, in a taverna, which obviously sometimes works a lot cheaper, or if you have a big budget, then why don't you just go for a yacht weddings? You can either have your own wedding there on board, or you can just have your reception. Then we have the honeymoon suite on the Sea Star, for example, which is absolutely fantastic.
Weddings in Cyprus come in many forms, and many couples choose to marry at their hotels. Couples looking for lively nightlife will love this hotel. The clubs and bars of Aya Napa are just a short distance.
Hi, my name is Cleo Papaglianthus. I work for the Athens Suites Hotel, and I'm here to organize the weddings. We do about 200, 300 weddings per year, and they are in a very nice location next to the beach, and everybody, they have a nice pleasure time.
We are a five-star hotel, nearly with 300 rooms, capacity up to 700 people. We organize a lot of weddings, got a lot of experience since the past, and we are here to make your holiday enjoyable.
We got married in Cyprus, the Adams Beach Hotel. Friends always recommend it. They come here yearly, and they recommend this hotel as well. Yeah. And they had fantastic reviews, and now we know why.
Yeah.
It's absolutely
really
dynamite.
Good. In our hotel, we do mostly civil weddings, church weddings in our chapel, which is located in the hotel grounds. We do renewal of vows, we do blessings.
The people that get married in Cyprus, they're doing a combination with holidays, getting married, and also to be honeymoon, because they do three things at the same time, which is nice for them. They're relaxing and organize their wedding, and after they enjoy their honeymoon.
Adams Beach Hotel has 296 rooms. Here is the lobby of the hotel. And I have the pleasure to show you all the hotel, the swimming pools, the restaurants, the bars, and the grounds. This is a Valentine's bar. Here are all the people that come for a nice cocktail with a live music, piano, and also it's a small section of a la carte restaurant. Here is our gym, which the bride, the groom, can come here and lose a few pounds. We have also aerobic classes and aqua massage. Here is the grounds of the hotels. We have five swimming pools, two jacuzzis. The people can relax the whole day here with two restaurants, the Vitaminas pool bar. It's open from the morning until night. And the Valad restaurant on the beach, which is open from 10 o'clock until 6 o'clock. We offer a la carte restaurant there. Hey, this is the chapel, St. Andrews, where the bride and groom can get married. And behind the chapel is the small island, the Nisi Bay. Okay, now we're going to the main course, to the most important thing, the honeymoon suite. We have six honeymoon suites, all of them with a double jacuzzi. Now is the big time. This one is the Apollo honeymoon suite.
Most of our wedding couples is staying some extra time for a week after the wedding, so they enjoy it as their honeymoon.
We have six honeymoon suites, all of them with a double jacuzzi, different style and different colors.
The hotel is 20 minutes distance to the town, and for the airport is about 35 minutes distance from Larnaca Airport to come over here.
There are different restaurants, outside, inside, choices of bars. We have several swimming pools, jacuzzi, health club, gym, hair salon, spa, beauty treatments, anything you need.
Most of the couples that get married in Cyprus is from England, Ireland, Scotland. When the couple, they arrive in the hotel, they come to us. We take the couple, we show them the venues, the restaurants, we talk about the facilities and everything, and we finalize the wedding.
The advantage of getting married in Cyprus at the Adams Beach is you've just got the beautiful settings, the weather, straight away the weather. And it's just absolutely gorgeous, really is gorgeous, well and truly. It can be very difficult getting family and friends over and organising the wedding itself, but when you've got the holiday reps back home and the holiday reps here and the hotel staff here, from beginning to end, it was just very helpful.
From my experience, getting married in Cyprus is very stressless. People, they enjoy their holiday. They feel nice with us. They trust us.
Yeah, I think it's a lot easier. They just take control for you. Yeah, definitely.
It's probably the easiest thing I've ever done, getting married up here.
Good choice.
We had 27 guests, and they were very, very pleased with the whole stay.
Every one of them just said it was one of the nicest weddings they've ever been to.
The usual wedding starts an hour before the ceremony, where all the guests, they meet up in our bar area. They spend their time until the ceremony in the bar area, having some drinks. Then they go outside for the service, or to the garden, or to the beach area. This is followed by the pictures. They can use all our hotel grounds for the pictures. Once this is done, we go back to the cocktail reception area. And later on, they are having their dinner outside in one of our restaurants.
Words just can't describe it. Really can't. It's just breathtaking from beginning to end.
We always try our best to meet the convenience, so if it's possible to arrange it, we're gonna do it.
The highlight of my wedding day was the whole day, very much so.
For holidaying couples that are looking for a real change of scene, visiting one of the island's villages will provide them with a fascinating insight into the everyday life of Cypriot people.
This is an area before you enter the Baths of Adonis where you can have a look at some traditional old Cypriot furniture like bedding and some traditional dresses. And you can see some other utensils as we go through this room here where you have the old iron that they used to use and some other bits and pieces for making bread and so on and so forth. Here we have an old water mill whereby you can see the millstones on the top. Water used to turn the stones and then they used to put the wheat in and they used to get the various grades of flour coming through.
Coming up, we visit a monastery that has been converted into a luxury spa. Another couple tie the knot. We tour the Capo Bay Hotel in Protaras. Couples who decide to get married abroad, the Mediterranean island of Cyprus has become one of the world's most popular destinations. Many hotels offer wedding packages to suit all budgets and tastes.
Capo Bay is based on the Fichtre Bay. Fichtre Bay is the most famous beach in the Protaras area. Capo Bay is based in the main center of Protaras. You will feel that you are in the center of Protaras. And at the same time, you can get the feeling that you are away from the center, being in front of the gardens of the hotel and in front of the beach. So when a wedding couple, a future wedding couple, wants to get married here, then we are always trying to make them happy. This is the most important for us and for them as well. This is going to be their best day of their life. So we're always trying to do the utmost.
Welcome to Capo Bay Hotel in Protaras. This hotel has been built up 1985. Recently, we just finished 2 years project with complete renovation, and this is the result. Reaching the room which the wedding couples may choose to stay and enjoy their honeymoon and the weddings. So you can see now this is the one of the luxury rooms, as I said. It's the queen size bed. It's very spacious. This is the toilet, the WC. Through this you can go directly to the spacious bathrooms. As you see, there's private jacuzzi, jets, whatever you need for the honeymoon. It used to be the heavy, old-style hotel, and we decided to go to the for the minimalistic kind of thing. So we tried to become a minimalistic hotel. Now we are coming to the completely new kind of rooms which we redesigned. It's duplex garden suite, which, as we're gonna see, you enter the master bedroom and then we're gonna slowly go down to the lounge area. So this is the master bedroom. Over there is a private bathroom as well, from two separate units. So this is the lounge area, which can accommodate again another two people on extra bed. And this kind of room also has the private jacuzzi outside. Okay, now we're entering our spa area, which offers full body treatments and whatever you need to treat yourself. This indoor swimming pool is 20 meters long, so when you want to have a peaceful swim without anyone, you can enjoy it. Now we are entering our hammam. It's just basically sitting on very warm surface and just relaxing with the aroma. And if you feel really hot, over there you can use ice to cool yourself down. This is our sauna. It's just a nice relaxing place within with the stones and the steam which goes up to 70 degrees and the humidity is around 65. So now we've got one more specialty, which is sanarium, which operates on the same principle as a sauna, but it's on the lower temperature. That's why it's recommended only for women.
Now we are at the tombs of the kings, where rich Romans were buried of the times. I mean, they are called tombs of the kings, but no royals were buried here. The people who were buried here, they were high-ranking officials of the Roman period. And the tombs resemble the houses of the times. The tombs were modeled on the houses of the period, and they are carved out of a solid stone. And tradition has it that they were even used by the Christians of the times when they were prosecuted. Because of their religious beliefs, they were hiding in the tombs just not to be killed by the Romans. There is a tomb that way that we could visit, or we could visit some more down there. This one is a very deep one by the looks of it. I mean, you see how it goes. It reminds you of Egypt at times, huh? You remember what I mentioned earlier about the tombs being modeled out of houses of the times where the dignitaries were buried. I mean, this is a classic example with columns of Doric influence, you know, surrounding the square.
Back at the Capo Bay Hotel, wedding coordinator Katerina is in the final stages of planning the wedding of one very happy British couple.
It's Joanna and Andrew. They're a very lovely couple. They were looking forward to it long now, more than a year. And I'm sure we're going to meet their expectations, as we've done with many couples before. We haven't got long before wedding, 10 minutes left, just to assist with the guests and the groom to bring them in the ceremony venue. And then that's it. We're going to witness the wedding. So I'm in Capo Bay since 98, and the last 9 years we do weddings. I really enjoy it. Is everybody ready?
Yes. Oh, yes.
Should we ask the groom first?
Yeah.
Andrew, ready?
Yeah.
Big day, you've been waiting so long. Okay, we'll slowly make our way to the ceremony venue.
Barbara, right.
Yes, you'll wait by the lobby. Once Mandy come with the bride, then you'll escort the bride all the way down, okay? I'll just get the groom and all the guests, and you'll come with the bride and bridesmaids.
Right, thank you.
Have you got stress? Are you stressed?
No,
nervous?
No.
Nervous? No?
No, fine.
No, fine. Bottom up. You will enjoy that. Andrew, you're still here? I'm looking around. I thought you escaped. Best man? Who is best man?
Yes.
Okay, let's go. Could you please follow us? Ladies? Groom stands here. Best man next to the groom. Bride will stand to your side. Bridesmaids?
Proposed to about 2 years ago now in Cyprus, so that's kind of why we decided to get married over here as well. No, I'm not nervous. No, I'm fine. Yeah. No, I'm all right. I'm all right. Yeah, just waited a long time, so yeah, looking forward to it. Yeah.
Joanna finally arrives, and an emotional Andrew finally gets the chance to marry the girl of his dreams.
I call upon all persons here present.
All persons here present.
To witness that I,
Andrew Aspinall,
accept,
Joanna Hargreaves,
as my lawful spouse, to love and to share with you,
as from this day,
moments of joy and sorrow,
wealth and poverty,
happiness and sadness, throughout our life, until death do separate us. Yes, from this moment I pronounce you husband and wife. You are joined together by your free consent in matrimony and your each other love, fidelity and respect throughout your life. This marriage constitutes the fulfillment of your life and links your destinies of good and rainy days in happiness and sadness, in wealth and poverty, until death do separate you.
Yeah, I'm better now. Yeah. Nervous before, but... Well, I wasn't nervous, but yeah, I'm fine now.
Another perfect wedding in Cyprus has gone off without a hitch. Another job well done by Katerina.
Emotional, I think. It's nice to see that all the efforts, they brought a very big, good result.
Couples looking for a relaxing wedding day destination can opt for something a little different.
Hagia Nargyri used to be an old monastery with over 300 years of history. People used to come here for the healing waters. That is good for the arthritics, for stomach diseases, for your skin also. And people in the old time, they used to drink it also because it's good for your metabolism. But due to the development of the area, it couldn't remain as a monastery. So it became a motel, and we renovated and extended to a luxury spa resort with a 56 rooms, including bungalows and suites. And of course, one of the biggest spa in the whole island with 22 treatment rooms, and it's about 2,500 square meters. Now we are at the bar of the resort. We kept the original the floor. It's over 300 years of history, and people can enjoy music, their drink, while there's a fireplace also here. Now we are at the pool area, and behind you can see the bungalows. We are having garden bungalows and spa bungalows. The spa offers a few unique treatments in the whole world, like the siesta bath. We're having aromatherapy. We're also having the total experience. A lot of yoga and holistic treatments can be done here also. That's the old church of the old monastery. So we also renovate this church, and also we can do in the weddings here, and people can have in their ceremony either at the pool or also in the cava that they can use for private use there. Now we are in one of the monks' rooms. Actually, those were the original rooms that the monks used to sleep. So we renovate them. having all double bed, their own veranda, and also they have the facility of healing water in the bathroom. Most of the building, we kept the original character of the old monastery that is built with a stone. So the temperature is, it's cold, in those rooms. So they will, I believe that they will hardly use the air condition even for the summer. The spa, as I said, is about 2,500 square meters. It has 22 treatment rooms. We have three indoor swimming pools with healing water. And there are three levels. In the lower level, there is a mini gym and two VIP rooms for those that they want to use the healing experience by themselves, not sharing with other people. That has the massages rooms.
Coming up, we tour the five-star hotel, the Four Seasons, visit the world-famous Adonis Baths and Waterfalls, and meet another happy couple. Cyprus is the mythical birthplace of Aphrodite and Adonis, making the island one of the most romantic holiday destinations in the world. Every year, thousands of couples from abroad enjoy their weddings and honeymoons in this perfect setting.
The type of couple that we actually organize weddings for are all varied. We have very young bride coming up with a full big dresses, or you have renewal of vows, sort of older couple who've been together for years and years who want something nice and quiet. So there's no actual stereotype, it's very varied.
Sometimes it's just the bride and groom that come themselves and we can arrange it just basically for them, just photography on the beach and just a bottle of champagne, a small cake, all right up to about 100, 150 guests.
We as a family-owned business have been on the market for a long time. We've got an extensive experience and we can guarantee everything we promise.
One of the questions we're asked all the time is, how do I carry my wedding dress on board? Now, we use, obviously, charter flight as well as scheduled flights. On number of charter flight, we actually give the bride an extra suitcase just for the wedding dress. But we have airlines such as Cyprus Airways who actually are very generous and give the bride and the groom an extra 10 kilos so they can each have 30 kilos of baggage, which obviously helps with all the wedding outfits and everything else they want to bring in. And really, it's very important to have somebody here to actually organize everything for you. You need the wedding coordinator to organize everybody, to make sure everybody has got their right buttonhole pinned on. When the registrar arrives, it's definitely not a luxury, no. It is a necessity more than a luxury.
The Four Seasons Hotel in Limassol offers a five-star service and a great setting for your wedding reception.
My name is Jennifer Tarrant and
My name is Martin McGillicuddy and we're married since Wednesday. We went to a travel agent and we were just, you know, we wanted to see where we wanted to go. I mean, we were open to all options really, but we were told Cyprus was the place for weddings. As Jen said, anything you want, you can get it here. You know, we had looked at Four Seasons and we're just blown away by the luxury of it.
We had really high standards and also it was just such a fantastic setting.
We're actually on the beach. We have one of the finest beaches in Limassol. It's a blue flag beach. And we're in one of the more upmarket suburbs of the city. And Limassol, obviously, being the second largest city on the island, it's a very commercial town. It's full of life all year round. It's got the best restaurants, bars, nightlife, most sophisticated areas for visitors to see, as well as the usual share of historical interests like the Limassol Castle and Kurium Amphitheatre just outside and the Amethyst ruins down the road from here.
It had everything and we didn't want to leave anything to chance, so that's why we kind of went with the Four Seasons in the end.
Welcome to the Four Seasons Hotel in Cyprus. This is our main lobby, reception behind me and our main bar in the distance. We're a five-star luxury hotel in Limassol on the south coast of Cyprus, opened in 1993 and had a full renovation in 2005-06. So we're basically brand new again. We have a full range of facilities from swimming pools to a gymnasium, a lovely Shiseido spa, lots of wedding, conference and function facilities, as well as 5 restaurants and 5 bars in the hotel. We're just about to enter our honeymoon suite, which is very popular with our wedding and honeymoon couples. This is the living room area of the suite, complete with 42-inch plasma screen, sitting area and chaise-longue on this side. The suite offers a lovely, spacious, private balcony with sea view, complete with a pair of sun loungers and dining area. Wedding and honeymoon couples love this bedroom. It comes complete with a round, king-size bed with silk sheets and above starlight, artificial of course, but equally as effective. We have 7 very good suites of this caliber that we have, but each one is decorated independently and individually, so no two are the same.
For those couples who want to really spoil themselves, there is somewhere even more special to stay than the bridal suite.
This is our fabulous royal suite. It's 250 square meters of luxury, and for those guests of ours that really want to have a lavish honeymoon, it's the ideal thing. Through here is the master bedroom. Lovely king-size bed, plenty of wardrobe space, a nice large dressing area. The bathroom of the Royal Suite offers a lovely jacuzzi and a built-in power shower and steam room. Here we are outside on the private terrace and pool area of the Royal Suite. This offers just as much space outdoors as the suite offers indoors, and offers a separate sitting area, outdoor dining area, and a lovely hammock for those relaxing moments, with these fantastic views out over the pool and the sea. This is definitely a party suite, and we've often had actual wedding receptions privately taking place up here as well. We can decorate and dress the area with flowers and various arrangements and have buffets up here. We can cater for a lunch or dinner for up to 40 or 50 people on the terrace of the Royal Suite. The private pool of the Royal Suite is set up on an elevated level, so as you can see, when you're actually in the pool and looking out to sea, you have fantastic views and relaxing whilst watching the people at the pool down below. We have a wedding department, and we also offer the services of a wedding coordinator. There's no 5-star hotel is complete without offering everything that somebody needs for having a good, relaxing and comfortable holiday. And our facilities include the Shiseido Spa. This is a very exclusive brand. There's only 5 in the world. And our particular spa has 15 treatment rooms and has a signature treatment, which is our 2-hour face and body ki massage, which is a fantastic treatment, the most relaxing thing you could ever do, and an ideal facility for a bride or groom to take advantage of the day before or the morning of the wedding. This is our St. George's Chapel. It's proved very popular with the weddings market since we opened it last year. So the reason why we made a big double door like this was to facilitate having the ceremony here at the entrance when there's a lot of people, so that we can have the gathered guests in front, seated in front of the chapel. And if it's a small wedding with up to 10 people, obviously that can take place inside, with the guests inside as well.
It was very easy to arrange. We had a wedding planner. She arranged it all for us.
It's a very simple procedure compared to many other countries. That's one of the reasons why Cyprus has become so popular for the overseas weddings market.
The normal way to do it is they have the civil in the morning and the Catholic ceremony in the afternoon. Louise said we'd be waiting around too long in our wedding dress and Jen would be too hot.
Yeah.
So we did it on Wednesday and had the Catholic ceremony on the Thursday. But as regards organisation, no issue. She did everything for us. Fantastic. Absolutely brilliant.
And she focused in on the smaller details too, which was very important to us. You know, things down to the flowers, for the arrangements for the tables, the confetti for outside the church. She just did all the details. I was quite worried about getting the hair and makeup done, obviously, you know, in a foreign country. But the lady that did the makeup was English originally, so, and the lady doing the hair was Cypriot, so she was able to translate, and everything just went perfectly on the day. There was nothing I could fault, and we really did have high standards coming over here, and we're expecting the best for our guests. There was 38 people in total, and everyone involved was absolutely superb.
The overseas weddings, particularly from the UK, vary considerably. A wedding is a very personal thing, so it's up to everybody's individual tastes and likings as to what they want to have and how they want to do it. And so really there's never two the same.
I suppose a big thing in Ireland is the weddings could be up to 200, 300 people in Ireland, and a lot of people feel they have to invite neighbours and aunts and uncles that you mightn't see that often, but you know, I suppose you're obliged to invite them.
One of the main reasons for the increased popularity of weddings in Cyprus is of course the cost element, and it's a question of budget, obviously, as all things are, but people can come over for their wedding, bring with them 10, 20, 30 or anything, sometimes up to 50 guests. And the whole cost of the event, the flights, the wedding itself, and the subsequent honeymoon, which the couple will stay for afterwards, be it 1 week or 2 weeks, as a total package price, will often come to less money than the actual wedding in its own back in the UK.
And people made it a holiday for themselves. Yeah. A lot of people came for 2 weeks, you know, so they made it their family holiday as well.
You have wonderful sunshine, consistent weather, beautiful settings, beaches, parks, gardens, palm trees. What more would anyone want? It's a heaven on earth, really.
We've been, you know, saving and planning for a year and a half for the wedding, and it just went... It went by in a blur, I suppose. You know, I'd be floating along for the day, but it was, I couldn't fault anything about the day. I'd do it again in the morning. So it was absolutely fantastic. But then that was down to everyone involved, between the wedding planner, the hair and makeup, the priest, the hotel, everyone.
Cyprus was also the setting for one of the greatest love stories of all time.
Here we come to the Adonis Baths. According to the Greek mythology, the playground of Adonis and Aphrodite. Aphrodite was the goddess of love. Adonis was, according to the mythology, a very pretty man that Aphrodite fell in love with, and he became her lover. It is believed that the descendants of Paphos are a product of their love affair. Rumor has it that if a man jumps in the waters here and has a bath, he will become very strong, and if you are old, then you will become younger again.
You might spend many years or just a few weeks planning your wedding day and honeymoon in Cyprus, but the memories will stay with you and your partner forever. All that is left is to wish you a wonderful and romantic wedding in Cyprus.